So guys, well, we have a program, right? This is our program. Now, let's do the dry run process for this. See what happens, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I'm just doing the dry run for this program. How to do the dry run? The meaning of the dry run is you just need to check what is the current status of your variable in the memory and at each and every phase, at each and every stage. Because here we're going to use the for loop. So we should know, I should know that because this loop is going to iterate 10 times, right? So I should know that at each and every step, at each and every phase, what is the situation of my memory? So let's start first. Okay, how many variables I have, guys? How many variables
one,
we have, guys?
Two. I and C.
Two variables. Okay. I have I. The second is sum. If you observe, right now when I'm initializing, when I'm declaring the variable sum, at the same time, I am initializing it with the zero. And there is nothing in the I. Now, clear screen. So this is the condition of my memory. Now I'm showing you the memory. Clear screen. After the clear screen, please mute your mic. There is background noise. Now let's start with the for loop. So here you will understand that how actually for loop works. So first, what you are doing, I is equal to 1. Okay, so I is equal to 1 means what I am doing, I have initialized the value of I with the 1. After that it will check the termination condition. It will check is I is less than or equal to 10, yes or no. Right now, this is my first phase. Is 1 is less than or equal to 10?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, 1 is less than 10. Yes, ma'am.
If that termination condition is true, then it will come inside the loop. So first it will go for the initialization, that is I is equal to 1. After that, it will check. Every time it will check actually. Initialization done at the very beginning point, one time only. This step, every time it will check. Is 1 is less than or equal to 10? Yes. Then it will come inside the loop. Okay. Now inside the loop, what it has to do? It has to do sum is equal to sum plus I. Means what I'm doing, I'm performing sum plus I. What will be the answer? 1 plus 0. Means 1, and I am assigning this value, the answer, in sum. Okay, means I got 0 plus 1, means I got 1, means now my sum will be 1. Now this is the first step, first phase done. Loop, inside the loop, first iteration done. We call it iteration. First iteration done. Now second iteration. So entry point, and this is the exit. But after doing this execution, it will go here. I plus plus. Okay. Means what I need to do? I plus plus means we increase the value of I by 1. So simple, the I 1 will become the, I will become the 2. So finally, I am done with the first iteration. And now, this is my 2. Sorry, this 2 will come over here. Sorry. Two. Now again it will check. Again it will check for this. I is less than or equal to 10. Is 2 is less than or equal to 10? Yes. Then it will come inside the loop. It will perform the operation. And this operation means 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1. And I got 3. So now my sum will be replaced with 3. This is the second iteration done. Now again it will go to the I plus plus, and my 2 will become 3. Again it will check here. I less than equal to 10? Yes, it will come inside the loop. And then sum plus I. Sum plus I means 3, it's 3. That is 6. So again, my sum will become 6. Iteration done. Again, 3 means again it will go to the I plus plus. So it will become 4. And this way, up to 10. Right? And at the moment, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. See, suppose right now my value is 10. Is 10 is less than or equal to 10? Yes, it will come inside the loop. It will perform the operation. And again, it will do the 11, I plus plus. And again, it will check. Is 11 less than or equal to 10? No, it is not less than or equal to 10. And so it will come out from the loop and it will execute the next instruction. This is how you can do the dry run of any program by checking the status of your variable inside the memory. At each and every iteration, after each and every iteration, what is the status of the variables? Understood, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Ma'am, one question.
Yes.
We wrote I equal to 1, then we put a second semicolon, and in the second section, we have written I is less than equal to 10. Are those both I the same, ma'am?
Yeah, same. Means, see, in the very first, okay, see this. What actually we are doing? See, here I have I is equal to, this is my starting point. This is my initialization. Means I have initialized the value, initialize I with the value 1. Now this is done. But every time you will rotate the loop, every time you will enter into the loop, every time it will check. Before entering inside the loop, it will check. I less than or equal to 10? If yes, then and only then it will come inside the loop every time. And once it will done with all the statements, it will go for the increment or decrement. This is something like.
I had the question that I will always be less than equal to 10, but because the value of sum is changing, the value of I is not changing. Sum equal to sum plus
I. It is changing, Sashwat. See, we have done I plus plus.
After every iteration, it increases by 1.
Yeah. How okay. Actually it works? How actually okay. It works? See, guys, how actually it works? Very first, it will initialize the I by 1. This is done. First, my execution will start from this point. This is done. Okay. After doing initialization, it will come to this statement to check the condition. That if this condition is true, then it will go inside the loop. And it will perform all the operations. Here, right now, we have only one statement. It might be possible that we have multiple statements. It will perform all the statements. After executing all the statements, it will go to the I plus plus or increment decrement section, third section. Then it will do the I plus plus. After doing the condition, that is it true? Every time you do this thing. So the flow is something like this. First this, then this. Then this, and again this. So at the moment it will get false it will come out from the loop.
Yes, ma'am. Got it.